unlike in BPD with triggered dissociative episodes of repetition compulsions that are experiences from the past being superimposed dissociatively on the here and now, it could be said that the narcissist is living that out in a much more defended and actually perhaps not consciously known but calculated way in most everything that they do and say with others. So the narcissist needs to be right about everything. We know that, right? The narcissist needs to feel entitled, has a very big ego, which is, you know, in an intellectual way can be an amazing strength, but without the emotional balancing sort of same kind of developmental growth, which is missing in narcissists, from arrested emotional development also, just at a different stage than BPD, their grandiosity, their egomania, they're always having to be right, the calculated way in which they will target people who are empathic, empaths, have a lot of empathy, maybe have their own woundedness or own pain, codependent, people that will just give them the admiration and the adulation and the mirroring they seek. Now, the mirroring that they actually need, which can actually be effective in therapy if you can get a narcissist into therapy, is what they want is to be perfectly mirrored, to have everything they say and do be mirrored back by who, you know, those around them as being fantastic, absolutely over the top, wonderful, great, you're the best at, super, fantastic, you have a right to be here, you're so welcome here, you're the greatest thing since sliced bread, well, not even, you're better than sliced bread. And so in that presentation, which is a grandiose overcompensation for a wounded little child walking around, but they're not associated with their pain often in the same way that people with BPD are. They're more removed, they're more distant, they have stronger defenses. And so they're intent on making sure that they get that supply that fills them up by making sure that you carry their pain for them. So the narcissist is very projective, very calculatingly blaming, and will scream at you often if you don't agree with them and don't perfectly mirror what they want to hear, as opposed to maybe what's really your experience with them. They're right fighting through all of these realities about them. And so what happens if you don't mirror back that grandiose, perfect sense of entitlement and sense of perfection and being better than everyone else? See, this is how narcissists are, whether they know it or not, overcompensating for the fact that they have this great, big, dark, deep hole inside of them where feelings should be, where feelings could be underneath that layer of darkness, because that's how far away and defended from their emotions narcissists are. 95% of the time, if not 100% of the time. And so they have calculated agendas and calculated ways of controlling others and of throwing out what might be some pain from beneath that big, dark, empty space inside onto others and blaming them. So you might be standing there with somebody who's got a narcissistic personality disorder and they're having a rageful moment because you said something that, yeah, it's a trigger kind of way it happens for them too, but it's not the same as in BPD. So maybe the narcissist is looking for a certain sentence back. They want what they want, how they want it, when they want it. Of that you can rest assured. Now, how are you supposed to know, even if you cared to try, and many people do, at any moment of the day, what exactly it's going to be that they want? And then when they're pushing you away or raging at you and yelling and screaming at you for what they're doing, but telling you in that gaslighting way that you're doing what they're doing, that's a narcissistic version of right fighting. they live their lives in an overcompensatory style because of what isn't inside, what isn't felt inside and known inside. They live through others, and that's what narcissistic supply and fuel is about. It's not so they see others very much, most of the time, if not always, as just objects to be used and mined so that they can feel filled up in a way, because otherwise, left to their own devices or left alone or not given that fuel or that filling up for whatever reason, then they're just going to be enraged by that and protecting and right fighting about how wrong you are and how, you know, we're all peons in the eyes of a narcissist. And this can also unfold, by the way, as I did a video yesterday about people who have comorbid BPD and NPD. Then you can see both these presentations at different times from those individuals comorbidly diagnosed. And it's really important, you know, for those in treatment, if they get to treatment, to be able to understand and learn and gain more awareness about the fact that nobody, even those who really try and seemingly want to, can mirror somebody's everything all day long, 24/7, especially when you have to consider that you're being treated as an object by the narcissist and they don't see you. They don't care about you. You are just the mirror that they need to fill up their grandiose entitlement and overcompensatory calculating ways of trying to get through their lives, because they can't look at what's really hurting down deep inside, because it's blocked in their case by a humongous black kind of empty hole. And if anything touches that even for a second, they pop off, they rage, they're indignant, they may discard instantaneously, because they are being people, they are people walking around, I don't like this terminology, but it fits in a way, doesn't it? Wolves in sheep's clothing, wearing different masks, trying to get you to believe that they are one person, one way, one mask. When that mask falls away, people are like, what the, you know, who is this person? How did I get here? And why are you doing this to me? And of course, if you try to ask any of those questions to a narcissist, you know, you will be duly put in your place and duly everything will be turned around on you and you will be gaslit. And they take what they feel inside, or don't feel, but like experience as a lack of what they actually needed to get from you, needed to feel from you, and they turn that out with a vicious kind of right fighting and indignation about how dare you, because you're supposed to just give them what they want, how they want, when they want. You're not supposed to want anything. You're not really real to them. Because they don't have this understanding of, you know, the spectrum of human emotions and the reasons why people want to connect and interrelate. They have calculated only perhaps seemingly to them logical reasons for what they do without the emotions. And of course, there's a spectrum in narcissistic personality, so you can see some of this, and in some people maybe not so much of it if they just meet two or three traits or five traits versus like the whole amount of traits, or if they're a malignant narcissist versus maybe just someone with narcissistic personality disorder. And there are differences. But definitely by the time, you know, if you're dealing with a malignant narcissist, there's really no reprieve from what they want. And they are in an overcompensatory way, very stronger and very different from those with BPD. Always right fighting. And right fighting for the narcissist is not the same as it is for the person with BPD. Right fighting for the narcissist is about see me, applaud me, enjoy me. You're lucky I'm even giving you the time of day. I'm so important. You aren't. It's all that self-absorption of what is sometimes agony, but I don't know how they experience it, because unless they get down deep into the black empty hole inside under there, yes, there's a world of pain. But that's really hard to do with people with narcissistic personality or comorbidly BPD and NPD. But just know that the whole narcissistic presentation across the spectrum to varying degrees is all about this fight for right as well. And that if narcissists are trapped in this mindset, in this calculated, cold, unemotional, me, me, me place where they treat others as objects for supply and fuel, and, you know, they often find negative fuel the best. So it's like the second you might react, you know, you're getting really hurt, you might lose your temper, you might go, whoa, stop, this hurts. The second you give any reaction to a narcissist, you've just bit the juiciest hook for them. You've just given them that fuel and supply they want, no matter if you're really angry now and hurt yourself. So the goal really with a narcissist that hasn't gained awareness about this type of behavior, their calculated presentation and what all that really means, is to be as neutral as possible. Because the second that you give a response, if you show your hurt, if you show anger, if you try in any way to sort of defeat them, as some people suggest you can do in videos, they will come back at you with a voracious, just ferocious, annihilating, calculated response to again put you in what they believe is your place. But they will be filled up also, in other words, delighted that you reacted. And when you react, whether it's with a feeling statement or anger or whatever, or walking away, when you show them that they've got you, because that's what they're always working to do, is get you to fill them up. And they don't care about you. They don't know how to connect with you. They don't know how to receive what you're trying to give. And they don't know how to be mutual or reciprocal at all. And so what happens when you give that reaction, and it's hard not to, because I know it's very painful on the other side of a narcissist, to say the least. But the second you give that, watch for the smile. Watch for the smile out of the corner, one side of the mouth, alternating with the corner of the other side of the mouth, or just a great, big, wonderful smile on their face, because it's a gotcha. And that's what they live for, and that's what they're working for always, because they're so empty inside, and because they're devoid of so many emotions. They're not devoid. In other words, there's hope for them in treatment if they will get into treatment. But as they walk around the world, they are, you know, and trying to interrelate with the world, they are unaware of other people's emotions. They don't care. It's all about how they feel, how they look, images, everything. Different presentation styles and manifestations of this, whether it's covert or overt. But the point is, this is a narcissist, the whole stronger, unfortunately, defense mechanism nature of narcissism in narcissistic personality means that these people, narcissists, are right fighting with everything they do. And it's not the same as the way people with BPD do it, though. At the end of the day, if you're getting screamed at, it's probably no comfort to hear that. But if you're on the other side of a narcissist, or you're trying to work with them, you know, as a mental health professional, as I do, then you have to be ready for those explosive eruptions, which cannot really be addressed or soothed within, you know, maybe it can take weeks or months. And if you get there, it can be as fleeting as gone the next time they come to a session, because they just need to say to you, you know, as an object and as a also representation of object other, meaning the parent that they felt so hurt by or were really hurt by. They just need to tell you that you're wrong, that they know as much, if not more. They know way more than you know, and then the rest of us know we're just peons in their eyes. But the problem with that is they don't realize how they might get satisfied with their manipulative and gaslighting ways and abusive ways of getting some of that narcissistic supply or fuel. And the more negative, the more they enjoy it. And so that's what you have to start protecting yourself right now from if you're dealing with a narcissist or in a relationship with one, is to not fuel and support the grandiosity and the wanted and desperately needed mirroring of their perfection, their greatness, their, you know, they're just, they want the mirror to reflect the fantasies and the actual, sometimes I think they're psychotic breaks of what they think about themselves.